This is Neil Jones. We are here at Bloodstock with the headline band Kilswitch Engage and Adam. How are you?
Hello, Neil Jones. I'm fine. Thank you.
So listen, you've never played Bloodstock before.
No, sir.
In you come as headliners. A lot of people have been saying Kilswitch Engage has been long overdue, but what did you know about Bloodstock? Did you know that the fans were clamoring for a Kilswitch set here?
Clamoring? Are they?
Clamoring.
No, we're just happy to be back in the UK playing, because it's been quite some time, 4 or 5 years now. So it's good to be back, and we've missed y'all. Here we are, yeah.
So listen, we need to talk about new music, because we know that music is being created. It's been a few years, 2019 since Atonement.
Right.
I know that there was an interview recently where you said there's a lot of quality control going on. Mm-hmm. Give us the latest. When is this album going to come out?
Well, we are going to begin recording it in September. So depending on our workflow and our rate of progress, I would say, you know, it takes forever for vinyl, all that garbage. So probably not until next year still, even though we're hoping, me as the recording engineer, producer, I would like to have it done by the end of the year. That's my goal. So, but, you know, vinyl takes forever nowadays.
I was going to say Metallica had the right idea just by buying their own vinyl plant. Every band can do that, can they?
We don't have Metallica money, sorry. If they want to press it for us, that's
great.
Hi, Metallica. I want to press our vinyl for free. Thank you.
This is a personal request to Lars and James.
Yep, and hang out because I love you.
But listen, let's talk about the music then, because although you haven't started recording it, I'm guessing there are basic tracks down, right?
No basics, it's just all demos. Okay. So we're still at demo stages, but we have quite a bit of demos. And Jesse's been writing and rewriting and going back to the little chopping block, and then, you know, so it's nice. We decided to have everybody in the band become a part of the lyric writing too. So it's okay. Jesse will bring ideas. We say, we like this, we don't like this. You know, this is the idea, carry on with that. And so, yeah.
So has making a Kilswitch album evolved in terms of the way that it's put together? It sounds to me like this is probably the most collaborative.
So I've it's fine. In the past, I took a lot of it on my shoulders to handle a lot of the duties. But I think the last record in particular, everyone was just, they felt like a bit detached almost, because I was doing almost everything on my own. And, you know, I think they're just like, we don't even feel like we made a record. You know? So there's like, they want to be more of a part of the production process and the writing process. So I've made sure to keep everybody looped in and in the same circle. So the communication's key to anything, you know?
When I hear the word quality control, I sense someone sort of sitting there with a lot of chin stroking going, is this good enough? Is that your role?
It always has been, I guess, yeah. I do my best to try to make something that we're kind of proud of, yeah. So, you know, at the end of the day, it's up to me to make sure that everybody in the band is happy and we're all going in the same direction, you know? Yeah.
Next year, correct me if I'm wrong, will be the 25th anniversary of Kilswitch. First of all, I'm sure you're aware of that.
Fuck, you're right.
1999, right?
Yeah. Wow. We are old.
So you've almost answered my question, because I was going to say, had you thought about doing anything special? But you haven't maybe even realized, I don't know.
No, we're playing shows. We're writing music. I think that's it, man. You know, like, what else can you do? I guess we could do a special tour or something, but we got shit to do.
No looking back, always looking forward.
Yeah, I think that's a good way to be. Yeah. Yeah.
On the last album, of course, there was Chuck Billy was on there. Mm-hmm. You know, you had Mike on there as well. You had all sorts of, a couple of guests on there. Do you think you'll throw the invitation list out to a few people this time around?
I think so. I have a few names in mind. I just think it's fun to collaborate with people, and you know, just like a little splash of a different voice is always kind of cool. You know what I mean? Especially a voice that we love. You know, like, it was fucking awesome to have Chuck Billy do something with us. I'm like, so stoked.
How did that come about? I mean, how does somebody reach out to Chuck Billy?
Well, we've toured with him in the past, so we just asked. That's it. So yeah.
We sort of briefly, cheekily referenced James and Lars. I'm guessing they would be the dream ticket.
Well, yeah, that's you know, James is why I started playing guitar. You know, one of the reasons. It was him and Van Halen and Angus Young. So it's just, yeah, you know, I've met him before. He's such a lovely guy. Oh my God. So
they say never meet your heroes, but obviously it was a good experience.
So I've met 2 out of 3, and they were both lovely.
Which one's remaining?
Angus Young.
Is this a bad moment where I tell you I've met him?
Sorry?
Is this a bad moment where I tell you I've met him?
You've met him. Was he nice?
Of course he was. He's Angus Young. He's got nothing to prove, right?
Okay. All right. Fair. Yeah.
I think the funny thing, if you were to meet Angus Young, is the difference in height, because I was towering over him like you are towering over me.
He's an itty bitty man, yeah.
You know, he would be literally kind of like waist.
No. So he's full on Hobbit then.
Listen, we can't say anything bad about Angus Young.
No,
he's the legend.
No, God, no, I would never.
So Angus Young, you mentioned, and James Hetfield. Who was the third one?
Eddie Van Halen.
Sadly, no longer with us, of course.
Right, right. Yeah, that hit me pretty hard, man.
But you met Eddie Van Halen.
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
Oh God. So his son Wolfgang, just liked our band at the time and was just like, let me know if you ever want to come up with the 5150. And I'm like, okay, I'll come up next week. Sounds good. And yeah, just got to hang out, see 5150, and of course, you know, Eddie was there, and then, yeah. I've actually went to their surprise show or their secret show in New York City with them at the Club Wa, which was insanity. We met up with them before they went on, rode in, like, the black SUVs with them to their club from their hotel, sat in backstage area with them, and then watched them play. I'm bumping elbows with John McEnroe, and I'm just like, what the fuck reality is this, man? And you know, then go with them after the set, out of there, back in the black SUV. And in the meantime, you know, John McEnroe and Jimmy Fallon are trying to get into the dressing room to say great show, and they're like, don't let them in. And I'm just sitting there with them, just like, thanks, guys. This is a dream come true. I can't believe, like, what I'm doing right now.
And when you know, when you grow up as a kid, like we all did, we had posters on our walls. I'm guessing you had Van Halen posters.
Absolutely.
To then be in that moment, did you get that sort of moment where you think back to being a kid and going, this is
just
incredible?
It's just surreal. It's just like, you, when things like that happen, you're just like, I can literally die tomorrow. I've achieved like my childhood dreams, you know, I've met my heroes, and it's just madness, you know? It's madness.
But let's talk about those itches which are still left to scratch. As a band, I'm guessing there are still those maybe places or venues or tours that you still want to do?
You know, we've never been to Greece. I'd love to go to Greece. I think where we haven't played, where I wish we did. I'd still love to go to Iceland, but I don't know if they're, you know, a big metal play. Maybe we're not metal enough for them. I don't know. And to be honest with you, it's just the thing that really makes it worth it is still playing the shows and seeing people having a good time. Because that's literally why we carry on with it, you know?
Remind me where you grew up as a kid.
Massachusetts.
So in Massachusetts, was there a venue that you thought, you know what, once I've played there, I will have made it, whatever made it means? And did you play there?
No and no. I've always just been like a whatever, like, simple dude. I'm not trying to take over the world with aspirations of being this and that. You know, like I said, it's just about having a good time and playing music, and, you know.
You must have one of those moments in your back pocket that you think, you know what, if I do nothing else, that moment that I did with Kilswitch, that particular thing, I'll always remember.
Opening up for specific bands, like, say, opening up for Maiden. Playing, you know, opening up a show with Metallica, that was fucking crazy. Wasn't technically, it was more like a festival. But still, you can say you're on the same bill. You know, just, yeah, moments like that where you're just, you know, seeing, like, literally like the biggest metal bands in the world, and you're like hanging out, you're bumping elbows with them. Yeah.
Well, listen, you are here headlining the opening night here of Bloodstock 2023. Let's just come back to the new material then. What sort of direction, what sort of sonic sound do you think it's going to have compared to other albums?
We're still doing what we do. We're just trying to push the boundaries and shake it up a little bit and make it not the same thing we've been doing for 20 something years. So yeah. Yeah.
Okay, listen, so we wait with bated breath until the back end of 2024. Is that likely?
Most likely. Yeah. It's the it's the deadlines, man. With the you have the waits for the vinyl because all the collectors want the vinyl, and you can't put out the music. You know, it's all got to come out simultaneously. I don't know. It's all silly, but it's the way it is. Yeah.
We are going to pick up the phone to Q Prime. We're going to get in touch with James and Lars. They have their own vinyl pressing plant. That way, we can get a Kilswitch album out quicker.
Yeah, sounds good.
Hey, listen, Adam, go and knock them dead. Headliners of Bloodstock 2024. Thanks for chatting to us.
All right, thank you.